Welcome to this HKUST video for undergraduate studies. This video is about our BSc program in Ocean Science and Technology. And I'm Stanley Lau from the School of Science, HKUST.
As we all know, the ocean is very important to our daily life. It provides us with food, medicine, mode of transportation, space for infrastructure, and therefore we have been taking a lot from the ocean. So the key question now is, how are we able to utilize the ocean resources in a sustainable manner? And the key to that question is knowledge. And therefore, we're introducing to you the BSc program in Ocean Science and Technology. The BSc in Ocean Science and Technology program is the first and the only one ocean-focused program in Hong Kong. It features an integrative curriculum that cuts across several disciplines of knowledge that includes basic science, technology, applied and socioeconomic aspects of the ocean science and technology. This program is suitable for students interested in taking a career path or higher study in the areas of conservation and protection of the marine resources, research and development in marine technology, ocean exploration, and other environment-related disciplines. As I've mentioned before, this program features a cross-disciplinary curriculum in which we have two major branches. One is the basic science of ocean processes and function. The other one is about the technological aspect regarding the latest scientific and technological development in the investigation, conservation, and management of marine resources. And altogether, there are three pillars in our curriculum that includes science, technology, and innovation. In the science aspect, you will be studying a variety of courses that aim to understand the basic functioning of the ocean environment. For example, biological oceanography, physical oceanography, chemical oceanography, ecology, and the relationship between climate change and the ocean, toxicity of pollutants in marine organisms, and also the functions of microorganisms to the marine ecosystem. In the technological aspect, you will be studying different techniques that we use to study the oceans. For example, remote sensing that use a satellite to scan the ocean surface for pigments, GIS and GPS, different kinds of marine bioresources that we can take for our advantage, pollution source tracking, different kinds of sensors and operations of instruments, and also the modeling of ocean current. In the innovation aspect, we have research projects in which you would find a question of interest of yourself, and then you will be investigating the question under the guidance of a faculty member of the Department of Ocean Science. You also will have opportunity to work in an organization during your internship to be exposed to the real life of a marine scientist. And you will also be engaging in courses like design thinking. For example, in this course, you may be designing a brand new vessel for us to take to the ocean for marine investigation. Now, different students will have different interests and different talents in the study pathway. Therefore, we have three options or tracks for you to choose from. Each track or option will have its own selection of elective courses. Depending on your interest, if you're interested in the interactions between organism and also the interactions between organism and the environment, you may choose to enroll in the marine ecology option. If you're more interested in studying the basic functioning of the entire ocean ecosystem, for example, how the water current flows and how the chemical reactions in the ocean take place, you may choose to enroll in the oceanography option. If you're really interested in research and you would like to pursue a career in the research pathway, then you may choose the IRE track. And for students who are taking the IRE track, we will give you additional required courses to shape up your research skills. There are four major pillars in our pedagogy that include the classical classroom instruction, practical sections in the lab. We will also take you out to the field for experiential learning. We also would have inquiry-based learning activities for you, for example, research projects. Supporting all four pillars are different varieties of learning activities, as I've mentioned, for example, lectures, lab sections, field trips, internship, etc. Now, we also emphasize in our curriculum that the students should go out of the classroom to see the real world because we are studying the ocean science. And therefore, we have a lot of experiential learning activities where you are going to the field to learn from the real life, and you also have exchange activities to go out of Hong Kong to see other parts of the world with regard to the marine environment and also their research activities in those places. Now, Hong Kong is very small, but we have a lot of marine resources for you to study from. For example, we have a higher number of coral species than what you can find in the Caribbean Sea. We have more than 1,000 different types of marine fish in Hong Kong. We have 2 marine mammals, and in total we have 5,700 marine species. But these organisms and precious ecosystems are being endangered by a lot of infrastructure projects in Hong Kong. Therefore, we need a lot of talents in Hong Kong to be able to understand the operation of the marine environment and find ways to protect them, although we need to take a lot of resources from the ocean. After you finish the program, you will be able to engage in 4 different disciplines for your career development or higher study. For example, conservation of marine resources, research and development in marine technology, ocean exploration, and other environment-related disciplines. If you're applying for our program through GPS, then our university has a general admission requirement of achieving minimum levels of 3-3, 2-2, 3-3 in these 6 subjects. For admission to ILE, there's a different calculation for ILE program. Depending on the subjects that you are taking for DSE, you may choose to admit to the School of Science through either Science A or Science B program. The 2 programs will give different weightings to the subject that you study. And for the details, you can look into this table. Since we are using school-based admission, if you'd like to study in our Ocean Science and Technology program, you could choose either Science Group A or Science Group B program as your first choice. If you're applying to our program using international qualifications such as IB or SAT, please visit our website for more information, or you can email us directly.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you will feel interested in our program, and I look forward to seeing you on our campus soon. Thank you.